Praise the Lord. Let me stand in the house of the Lord tonight. Amen. I'm glad to be excited. God woke me up this morning. Here he is. Did you get your cereal? Bless you. Praise the Lord. I'm excited about this youth service tonight. I'm looking forward to it. Been waiting for Sister Kasey to come preach for us. The devil tried to find her, but she's here. Amen. Praise the Lord for everyone that's been out here. We probably have some more come in. We don't know yet, but we're going to turn it over to Sister
Emily.
She's going to ask somebody to take her over. God bless the service tonight, so y'all just give her your attention.
God, use them in a mighty way, God. We ask God in your sense, and God, we praise you for it. God, we give you praise for everything. Jesus, precious. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Good job. Before I start out with anything else, I wanted to read something someone sent to my mom, a good friend of hers, and I thought I'd just share it tonight. Nothing you've been through has been wasted. I know at times you feel you've wasted time, moments, and years over what you can't regain again. A job, a marriage, a relationship, your health, the sacrifices, your time and service, and giving up something you love for God that broke your heart. You sit back and wonder, will I ever be happy again? Was everything I've been through worth the pain, the tears, the sleepless nights, the embarrassment? The Lord is saying, it's just preparation. Where are you now is no accident. What has happened to you didn't take God by surprise. He already initiated a plan of escape before you were formed. Mistakes, setbacks, disappointments, things outside your control. The plan was already made. I don't know your story, but only you and God know your story. He took you from bad company. He took you from rape. He took you from suicide. He took you when you were at your lowest. He took you when nobody wanted you. He took you when your money was low. He took you when you had kids outside of marriage. Why? Because he saw potential in you. As God is my witness, it gets lonely at times, but life can be fearful when you don't know what to expect. When you feel everything has been stripped away, when you feel there is no hope, when you wonder, how much longer do I have to wait? Who wants to feel rejection or disappointments? But it's in those moments when we experience the faithfulness of God. I want to encourage whoever I'm speaking to hold on. Before Joseph came prime minister of Egypt, he was in prison for years because of his brothers. He wasn't expecting that. In other words, what God has for you is something bigger than you've imagined. It's so much greater and better than what you had at first. It's something you never thought about or even prayed for, because nothing you've been through has been wasted. Your situation is going to change suddenly because all it did was reposition you for a blessing. God is getting ready to move. You're frustrated because you're on the verge. You're restless because you're on the verge. Your moment is coming sooner than you think. Remember, nothing you've been through has been wasted. It's shaped you, molded you, and prepared you for what God has for you.
Amen. Amen.
Page 6. Thank you.
Was needing prayers. I don't know why, but God does. Let's remember them tonight. Remember my lost loved ones? I got a lot of lost loved ones, brothers and sister-in-laws and nieces and nephews that needs to be saved. And let's also pray for little Avery, that little girl that I've been telling you about that's got the brain tumor. Let's continue praying for her.
Anybody else?
Remember my mother. She's struggling with breathing and high blood pressure tonight.
Amen. Remember me tonight, Austin, and remember my son, Craig, and remember my nephew's little girl.
Anybody else?
Remember me and my family tonight, and remember Danielle. She had her teeth and stuff pulled out today, and the anesthetic they gave her is got her a little bit emotional.
Anybody else?
Pray for us in our home. Remember Stacy, he had two tests done on his brain Tuesday, and we're waiting on the results of them. He's got an appointment at the eye doctor Tuesday. Also, that goes along with them, so y'all keep praying for him. A lady at our church, Mary, last night, she's got to have surgery Monday. She's got a place under her left arm, and they're pretty sure it's got cancer in it. She's got to have surgery on it Monday, so y'all pray for her. Keep praying for April. Messaged me and said her mom's in Louisville still with fighting cancer in her lungs and brain.
Remember mom in prayer. She asked me to request prayer for her. Continue praying for Ruth that God will improve in her body and stuff. And then remember the adoption Tuesday.
Also remember me and Joshua, and remember him. He was supposed to have an MRI the other day, but someone, nurses told him he needed to be careful, and we've been waiting to hear back from his heart doctors, because it's actually really critical for him, given his condition and stuff. So y'all remember, and also remember Sister Kasey, she brings forth the message tonight that it'll help someone tonight in the room service.
Amen.
Anybody else?
I also like for y'all to remember Cody, she has to have a tooth pulled Monday. And then Kaylee has to go have a sleep study done. And then she's looking at dental surgery coming up and probably tonsils. So just remember that the Lord would touch them, that the Lord would restore their health.
Amen.
Anybody else?
But also has to remember Sister Brenda Ballard's mama, Gertrude Taylor. She needs our prayers. She's
feeling
better, but she's still weak, so we need to pray for her.
Anybody else?
Remember the youth. Remember all the youth as they step out to work for the Lord.
Anybody else?
Remember Tommy.
Yeah. Anybody else?
Remember Johnny and baby. Johnny's been really weak. He's only been like an ankle joint. Get himself up a couple of times since Christmas. Stacy would have Stacy or Red has to pick him up and put him in the wheelchair to take him to work.
Anybody else have a prayer request? Did we get any on live stream?
Just Kayla for Danielle.
That be all? Uplifting every hand.
Hallelujah.
Pray to see you after all.
Bless you, Lord God. God, we thank you, Lord God, for this day. Thank you, Lord God, that you allow us all to be in the house of the Lord once again. God, be able to lift you up. God, be able to give you the glory and be able to give you the honor tonight. God, what honors do. Lord God, we pray that you bless these young people tonight, God, in the youth service, Lord God. I pray, God, that you use them in a mighty way. God, I pray, God, you bless, Lord, these needs and these requests. God, you heard each and every one, Sister Cavs, Lord, Sister Jen, Sister Casey, Lord God, Lord, all the requests, Lord God, it was given in. God, you heard them, Lord God, you know them, God. God, we ask that you would move up on them, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. God, we ask, God, that you would move upon our land and country, Lord God. Lord God, we pray for our president and our vice president, Lord God. Lord God, we pray for our senators and our governors and our congress, Lord God. Lord God, we just ask, God, that you give them the wisdom and the knowledge that they need, God, but save them most of all, God. Lord God, in anything saved, most of all, God, we ask God in your son's name, God. Lord God, as we pray for the peace in Jerusalem, God, and we pray for Israel, Lord. God, we just ask God that you would move, God, upon the Lord, your people tonight, God, have your way in this place, God. Not our will, but your will be done. God, we thank you, God, for this beautiful day that you have made. Lord God, the sun shining, Lord God, the warm weather. But God, we just want to give you praise tonight, God, for being able to be in the house of the Lord. Hey, God, to be able to lift you up tonight, God. Hey, God, to give you the glory, to give you the praise, God. Lord God, you said if we would lift you up, you would draw all men unto us, dear God. I pray, God, that you would bless those who sing tonight, God. Anoint them, Lord. Use them tonight, God. We ask, anoint Sister Kasey tonight. Touch her, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. We ask, Lord God. Oh, God, move upon little Kasey, grace, Lord God. She has to have these tests done. Cody, Lord God. God, we ask, Lord, that you would look on Tanya's mama, Lord God. You touch her. Lord God, you touch that blood pressure right now, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Lord God, Tanya, again, little baby, Lord God. I pray that you would touch it, Lord, little baby, Lord God, that little baby. God, it's got that brain tumor. God, we pray that you would touch her, Lord. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And Lord Haley, Lord God, it's got that tumor, Lord God, that they've done the surgery on. I pray, God, you continue touching her body. Lord God, and you bring her home safely, Lord God, and keep your hand upon that child that she's carrying. God, we ask, Lord, God, in your son's name, God, we give you praise, glory, and honor for it all. God, we just thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
I'm going to ask Sister Abby and Brother Matthew to come take up the offering. And I would like to ask Brother Austin to
pray. Lord, as I come before you, Lord, we just ask you, Lord, be with those that are here tonight, Lord. Just be with those that have been given, those that don't, Lord. Just ask you, Lord, be with those that have been given, those that have been given, Lord, they are for you.
This offer tonight goes to the young people.
Thank you. Thank you.
How